Hello students, today we will continue with the illustration under residential status. So the illustration number 6, see the question. Simon, an American, came to India on 20th December 2016. He was in India till 31st Jan 2018 when he went to Canada. He came to India taking up an employment in British Concern on 20th May 2018. He was sent to Japan for 6-month training on 1st November 2018. He was transferred to Singapore branch on 20th August 2019. Find out his residential status for assessment year 2019-20 and 2020-21. So in this question, we have to find out the residential status for 2 years. That is, for one is assessment year 2019-20 and another one is assessment year 2020-21. So I'll explain the question now. Now we'll simplify the question by preparing the rough working note. So here, Simon, he is an American citizen, came to India for the first time. American citizen, came to India on 20th December 2016. So, we will write here, working note, came to India on 20th December 2016. Next, he was in India till 31st Jan 2018. Means, he was in India till 31st Jan 2018 when he went back to Canada. Means, on 31st Jan 2018, he went back to Canada. So, he went to Canada on 31st Jan 2018. So he came to India on 20th December 2016 and he went to Canada on 31st Jan 2018. Means in between of this period gap, he is resident in India. Next, he went to Canada. Next, he came to India taking up an employment in a British concern on 20th May 2018. So, he came to India on 20th May 2018 means after he left to Canada, he was non-resident in India and he came to India on 20th May 2018. Next, he was sent to Japan for 6-month training on 1st November 2018. So, he sent to Japan means he went to Japan on 1st November 2018. So till that period he was resident in India. He came to India and he went to Japan means he was resident in India till 1st November 2018. So from 1st November 2018 he was sent to Japan for 6-month training on 1st November 2018. Next, he was transferred to Singapore branch on 20th August 2019. Means, after 6 months. So, we have to take the gap of after 6 months. So, went to Japan on 1st November 2018. So, next, for 6 months, he was non-resident in India. He went to for training. So, 6 months means, after 6 months means, he went for training on 1st November 2018. So, from 1st November to 1st December, 1 month. From 1st December to 1st Jan to 2 month. 1st Jan to 1st Feb, 3 month. 1st Feb to 1st March, 4 month. 1st March to 1st April, 5 month. 1st April to 1st May, 6 month. So, total 6 month he was non-resident in India. He went for training. So, after 6 months, he returned to India. So, that is, the last day of 6 months is 1st May 2019. This one we have to take. It is not given in the question, but we have to find. After training, he returned to India on 1st May 2019. So, till, means, in the period, for a period of 6 months, he was a non-resident in India. Next, he came on 1st May 2019. Next, he was transferred to Singapore branch on 20th August 2019. Means he left to Singapore. Transferred to Singapore branch means he went to Singapore on 20th August 2019. Means from the last day of 6th month, he returned and from there to transferred to branch, Singapore branch, he was resident in India. Then he left from 20th August 2019, he left and he went for employment there. He was transferred to Singapore branch, means he left for employment there. So, we have to find out the residential status for the assessment year 2019 and 20 and 2020 and 21. So, we have to find the days we have to calculate the days he was resident in India. Everywhere we have to find. Here, he was transferred to Singapore branch. He means he is Simon, an American citizen. He went to abroad. Singapore means out of India. He went to Singapore for employment means here for American citizen, exceptional rule is not applicable. So only for an Indian citizen leaving India for a employment, leaving India to abroad for employment, then he comes under exceptional case. So here for American citizen, if he leaves India for employment to abroad, means for Singapore, he must satisfy, he is having option of two condition. Anyone he has to satisfy, basic condition, he has to satisfy anyone. If he satisfies anyone, then he becomes a resident. If a Indian citizen goes for employment abroad, then he must stay in India for 182 days. Clear? Now we'll solve the solution. First case, so here we have to find the residential status for assessment year 2019-20. So we'll calculate first assessment year 2019-20. So for this assessment year, previous year is 2018-19. So this previous year starts from 1st April 2018 to 31st March 2019. Now in order to find the residential status, to become a resident, he has to satisfy any one of the basic conditions. So stay in India during the previous year. So that first condition is he has to satisfy 182 days during the previous year. So stay in India during the previous year, that is so we'll calculate. So previous year starts from 1st April 2018 to 31st March 2019. So now see 1st April 2018. So 2018 here, it comes here. So he went to Canada on 31st Jan 2018. Means he went to Canada on January 2018. We need from 1st April. Means he went to Canada. So he was not there after 31st Jan. When he came back to India on 20th May 2018. So in the 1st April, he was non-resident in India, non-resident. So he came to India, when he came to India, 20th May. So from this date, he is resident in India. So again, he went to Japan on 1st November 2018. So we have to find, so from 20th May 2018, he was resident in India during the previous year, that is from 20th May 2018, from 20th May 2018 till went to Japan 1st November 2018. So he was resident for till 1st November 2018, so in the year 2018. So we have to take 20th May 2018 to 1st November 2018. Now the year end is 31st March 2019. So we have to check whether after how many months he comes back. So after 6 months, after 6 months training, he came back to India. Means after 6 months means it is 1st November. So this is a November, this is on 1st May. This is a November 2018. So this is the 1st Jan 2019. So May means it is of the 2019 year. So he came back to India on 1st May 2019. Means he came back to India after this financial year end. This is the March. He came back to India on May month. So in this previous year, he was resident from 20th May 2018 to 1st November 2018. Now we'll calculate in the May month. So total 31 days in May month. So from 31 days, first 19 days he was non-resident. See, he came to India when he came to India on 20th May, means before that he was non-resident. So here we have to take May month, only 12 days, means out of total 31 days, first 19 days we have to exclude, and on the 20th date he is in India, means we have to include. So May 12 days, next month June 30, July 31 days, August 31 days, September 30 days, October 31 days, and he come back on 1st November. So November only one day. So we will get total 166 days, means he does not satisfy the first basic condition of 182 days stay in India, but he satisfy the second condition, means first 60 days stay in India. To complete the second condition, he has to satisfy 365 days stay in India during preceding 4 previous year. Since he is American citizen, goes for employment, we have to take his exceptional role is not applicable. He has to satisfy any one of the basic conditions. So we'll calculate the second condition, that is stay in India during preceding previous year. So stay in India during the year preceding previous year. So for previous year 2018-19, so preceding previous year will be starts from 2017-18, 2016-17, 15-16, 14-15. So we have to take likewise here, see working note, he came to India, first time he came to India on 20th December 2016. Before that he was non-resident in India. Right, he came to India on 20th December. American citizen came to India on 20th December 2016, means before that he was non-resident in India. So till 2016 we can take, till the academic year, till the assessment year 2016 we can take. So till here we is enough to take calculate. After that, if you take also he is non-resident, we'll get non-resident itself. So we'll calculate one by one. So assessment preceding previous year 2017-18, 16-17, 15-16 and 14-15. Next we'll take first one, working note, came to India on 20th December 2016. So first he came to India on 20th December 2016. So this 2016 he comes here. So in the year 2016-17, the year starts from 1st April 2016. But he came to India on 20th December 2016. So from that day he was resident in India. So from that day we have to count the resident days. So 20th December 2016, from that day till 20th December he came to India, and he went to Canada on 31st Jan 2018. So to 31st Jan 2018 does not affect here, means he went on next year, 2018 year, means he was there in India till this year end. So from the 20th December 2016 till the year end, that is 31st March 2017, we have to take. So we have to count how many days he was there in India. Next, he went to Canada on 31st Jan 2018, means till the 31st Jan 2018, he was resident in India, means from 1st April 2017 he was resident till 31st Jan 2018. So this year starts from 1st April 2017. So from that day he was resident in India till the year end. So here year end is 31st March 2018, but he was not there till 31st March, but he left to Canada on 31st Jan 2018, means we have to take 30 till 31st Jan 2018, because his residence from the year beginning till the year end, means he came to India on 20th December 2016, and he was resident till this year end, and next year start also he was there in India, and he left on 31st Jan 2018. So we have to count how many days he was resident in this year. So that is about 2016, came to India on 20th May 2018. This will affect to the previous year, May, 20th May 2018, we have already calculated. Next, after that we are not getting the year. Before that he was non-resident. So before 2016 he was non-resident. So we have to take non-resident, and we have to count the days. So for the first one, I have written here 306 days. So 306 days. So how we got 306 days, means the year starts from 1st April 2017. So April 30 days, May 31 days, June 30 days, July 31, August 31, September 30, October 31, November 30, December 31, and till the January 31. So till Jan 31 we have to take. So total 306 days here is he is resident here. Next one is 102 days, that is the day starts from 20th December 2016. So he came to India came to India on 20th May 20th December 2016. He came to India on 20th December 2016. So from December we have to take. So December total how many days? 31 days. 31 minus he came on 20th means we have to exclude 19 days. 31 minus 19 days we have to exclude. So total December 12 days, January 31 days, February 28 days since the year is year 2017, not a leap year, March 31 days. So totally 102 days he was resident. So now we have to see whether he is a ordinarily resident. So first condition is he should be stay in India for a first condition, first basic condition is not satisfied, that is he is not there in India for 182 days. But second basic condition is 60 days in the previous year, it is satisfied, more than 60, that is 166 days. Then 365 days during the four preceding previous year. So we have 306 plus 102 means more than 365, means he is a resident in India. He is a resident in India. But next one, we have to check whether he is a ordinarily resident and not ordinarily resident. Here, if you take next 7 years or 10 years, he was non-resident. He came on 20th December 2016 means before that he was non-resident. Means he does not satisfy the both the additional condition, that is he was not there, he is there only at least 408 days. Only 408 days he was there in India. He was does not stay in India for a 7 preceding previous year in, for 730 days and 2 year out of 10 preceding previous year. So he does not satisfy the both the additional conditions. So he becomes not ordinarily resident. Now see the note here. Simon does not satisfy the first basic condition of 182 days stay in India in the previous year, but he satisfies the second basic condition, that is 60 days stay in India during the previous year and 365 days more during the four preceding previous year, that is 166 days in the previous year and more than 365 days in the four preceding previous year. So he becomes a resident in India. So thus he is a resident. To him, exception rule is not applicable, means he has to satisfy any one of the basic condition. He can satisfy 60 days to become a resident. Exception is not applicable to him because he is a American citizen. Next, if you want write, since he is a American citizen. Next, second condition, second note is, in order to become ordinarily resident, he must satisfy both the additional condition. But Simon was resident in India less than 730 days in the preceding previous year. Hence, he is not ordinarily resident for the assessment year 2019-20. Clear? Next, we will find out the second case, that is finding the residential status for the assessment year 2020-21. So for a second case, assessment year 2020-21, for this assessment year, previous year will be 2019-20. So the previous year starts from 1st April 2019 to 31st March 2020. So in order to find the residential status, we have to find whether he applies the basic condition. So first basic condition, stay in India more than 182 days in the previous year. So stay in India during the previous year. So here, working note is same for them during the previous year. So previous year starts from 1st April 2019. 2019 year starts from 1st April 2019. 1st April 2019. He went to Japan on 1st November 2018. After that, he was not there in India, non-resident. And he came on 1st May 2019, means on 1st April, he was non-resident in India. So, means he was resident, he returned to India from 1st April. We have to count the days from 1st May 2019 till the next time period. 1st May 2019, next he was resident in India from 1st May and transferred to Singapore branch on 20th August 2019. So only for May, June, July, August. So for 4 months he was there in India here. So we have to take from 1st May 2019 till 20th August 2019 we have to take. Next, after 20th August he transferred to Singapore branch. So he was not there till the previous year end, that is 31st March 2020. He was not there. He went on 20th August 2019. Means we have to count the days from 1st May 2019 to 20th August 2019. So in the May month, 1st May, he came back after training on 1st May. So May 31 days, full month, June 30, July 31, August, he returned to Singapore. He went to Singapore on 20th August, means till 20 days he was there in India. Till 20 days he was there in India. So 20 days, total 112 days he was there in India. So he does not satisfy the first basic condition. Next we have to check whether he satisfy the second basic condition. So in that 60 days he was there in India during the previous year. Next we have to check whether he was there more than 365 days during preceding previous year, for preceding previous year. So stay in India during preceding previous year. Stay in India during preceding previous year. So for the previous year 2019-20, preceding previous year will be 2018-19, 2017-18, 2016-17 and 2015-16. So after he came to India on 20th December 2016, means before that, here I didn't forgot to say about non-resident here. During this period he was non-resident. He came to India on 20th 12 2016, means before that he was non-resident. Similarly here, he came to India on 20th December 2016, and before that if you take the years also, he was a non-resident in India. He is an American citizen, came to India on 20th December 2016, means the day starts from 20th December 2016. The stay in India during in India will starts from 20th December 2016. So we have taken the preceding previous year. Now we will calculate the days. So same working note, date will not change for the second case. So first he came to India on 20th December 2016, where it comes in the 2016-17, December comes here. So 20th December 2016, this year starts from 1st April 2016. So after April we will get 2000 December. So in the same year we will get. So from 20th December 2016 till the year end he was there in India. Till the year end he was there in India means he went to Canada on 31st Jan. So till the year end he was resident. So we have to count the days. So this is same as previous one. We can take directly the 1 or 2 days, or we can count again. Next he left went to Canada on 31st Jan 2018. So he went to Canada on 31st Jan 2018, means it comes here. So from 1st April 2017 to till 31st Jan 2018, so we have the count. So from the beginning of 1st April 2017 he was there in India, and he was not there till 31st March 2018, but he left on 31st Jan. He left on 31st Jan to Canada. So till that we have to take the days. Next, after that, 20th May came to went to Canada on 31st Jan 2018. So after that, till 20th May he was non-resident. Till 20th May, after that, after 31st Jan he was non-resident. February non-resident, March non-resident, April 2018 non-resident, May 20th he came to India, isn't it? 20th May he came to India. So from 20th May 2018 his residence starts till he came to India on 20th May. So he went to Japan on 1st November 2018. So 1st November 2018 also comes in the financial year 2018-19. So till 1st November 2018 we have to take. So he went to Japan on 1st November 2018. Next he comes back 1st May 2019. 1st May 2019 does not affect to this year. So this year end 31st March 2019. So he returned on 1st May, means does not affect to this year. So from 20th May 2018 to 1st November 2018 we have to count the days. So here 2017-18, 16-17 we have already calculated. See, How many days? Same gap. 20th 12 2016 to 31st March 2017. 20th 12. So 102 days we can directly take. And here from 1st April 2017 to 31st Jan 2018, same we can take 306 days. And one more year is 2018-19. This is 20th May 2018 to 1st Jan. So here we can find in the previous year, 2018-19 financial year. So here 20th May to 1st November 166 days. We can write like this, or we can calculate again like here. We can count. So totally how many days? 166 plus 306 plus 108 102, means he was there in India more than 365 days in the four preceding previous years. So he satisfied the second basic condition, that is 60 days plus 365 days in a during four preceding previous years. So he become a resident. Next we have to find whether he satisfy both the additional condition to become a ordinarily resident. But he stay in India only for period of 166 plus 306 plus 102, means less than 730 days. So he becomes not ordinarily resident. Now see the note. Mr. Simon does not fulfill the first basic condition of stay in India during for 182 days in previous year. But he satisfied the second basic condition of 60 days or more stay in India during previous year and 365 days more during preceding previous year. So he becomes a resident. Mr. Simon was in India for a period of 112 days in the previous year, right? See here, he was there in India for 112 days in the previous year. Since he was sent for 6-month training on 1st November 2018, he returns India after 6 months. So that I explained. Again, I written here 1st May. Means in the question, they have not given. He returned on 1st May 2019 after 6 month training. That we have to assume that after 6 months, he returned to India after training. So that is what after. So here we have taken into consideration of that period here, calculating stay in India during previous year. So from 1st May we are taking. So this is he is not given in the question, but we are taking because he is in India from 1st May 2019, means he came back after training. So this one you don't get confusion while you have ready solution, but when you solve by yourself, you really get confusion. So practice yourself, don't see the solution, just see the explanation for the question and work out. Next you cross check whether it is correct through the video. So Mr. Simon was in India, this is over. Next, as he is an American citizen, exceptions are not applicable. So he becomes a resident. He can satisfy the second basic condition as he is an American citizen. Next, to become an ordinarily resident, he must satisfy both the additional condition. His stay in India was for less than 730 days during 7 preceding previous year, not ordinarily resident. He becomes not ordinarily resident for the assessment year 2020-21. So both the assessment year 2019-20 and 2020-21, he becomes a not ordinarily resident.